think there's a lot of misconceptions, illusions, space orbit interpretations. Sometimes you gotta step back from the Illuminati business on the internet and think about some of your thoughts as an individual. I'm a firm believer in seeing the unseen, meaning that what you see, you don't see. The powers that be deal in mathematical equations. They're dealing commerce, they're dealing import, export of trade, the financial sector. They have their military on the chessboard of life to protect their coffers, their bank accounts, their offshore accounts, like Swiss bank accounts, what have you. As a man, as a woman, living in this world, period, you got to know where you at on the chessboard of life. Who is trying to control you? Who is trying to steer you away from the Most High? Are you spiritual or are you material? You got a lot of people that's walking around, they don't even know who they are. They just exist or cease to exist. Think about that for a minute. Let me see this camera roll. Hold on for a minute, y'all. Yep, we in there. But yeah, I mean, when you look at the dilemma, when you look at the problems, when you look at the entertainment field, then you got this this founding father of the hip hop culture, Bam Bada, all sorts of allegations, and people like what Star Chamber and all those guys going and attacking the man's character. It's a lot of confusion. I'm not gonna get into that. But I look at how this eliminates, how this castrates, mentally castrates the hip hop generation. You know, I grew up in that generation. That's my generation. When Bam Bada was on the scene, I was a little guy going to elementary school. Now to see this man get ridiculed and tore down from the frame is sad, and the comments that KRS-One made was definitely not intellectual. That was on a savage level when he commented, when he was posed that question about the allegation when it concerning Bam Bada. So that was totally out of line, I think, too. So that was kind of, you know, stupid. But when you got to get into the core of this thing, I see a sabotage, I see a destruction. They're trying to destroy a genre, which is hip hop, predominantly Afro-American, and still is. They're just trying to destroy it. That's the, whenever you have an ethnic group that's making a lot of money and surviving and living off the America's pork chop, which is wealth, living real nice. You know, black folks in America, man, like a 10-year period, we ain't never lived like this. Almost a 20-year period. Back then, not too long ago, we was in shackles and chains and working for people's plantations. So we came a long way, but we still got a long way to go. You see all this Black Lives Matter stuff. You see all this attack on the church. You see all this institutional racism, white supremacy, blah, 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 blah. All that is designed, order out of chaos by your ancient Illuminati, enlightened son of light brothers that's running around in suits in every institution. Feds, it's octopus. They, you know, they are not spiritual, they're material. Their God is the God that was kicked from the heavens and is on this earth with his flock, which is the fallen angels. These are the entities, these are the realms they're dealing in. And a normal person, Homo sapien, which is a human being, some of us can't understand that. These are the things these people dealing with. You gotta understand that. Understanding is everything. If you can't understand the wisdom and logic I'm talking about, I just send a prayer up for you, because you're not alone. See, you got two types of people. You got evil, good, vice versa, good, evil. Okay? It's in every institution, like I said. It's in your church house. It's in your job. It's in your household. It's on your technology. You got to monitor what comes in your house and what your kids watch, you know? You got porn 24 hours a day. You got all kinds of debauchery. You got people getting executed. You got subwebs, deep webs. You got other dimensions. I mean, if you don't put some spirituality in it, it's only going to be corruption at the end of the day. Y'all may see this this phone jump around, but don't even pay attention to that. Just listen to what I'm saying. Okay, I'm just checking, see, you know, just seeing if the camera is still rolling, and it is, and that's good. That's good for my part. But when you look at this, oh, by the way, happy Mother's Day to all the mothers across the world. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers across the world. We had this Temple of Baal thing. I heard the, you know, stories about that sinful place when they was, you know, sacrificing babies and stuff like that. We really, as a nation, and whoever hears this, we got to pray, because it's nothing new under the sun. You have this missing and exploited children, you know, your children on the milk carton that go missing. You had your, I seen a documentary on Highway of Tears, all these Alaskan, Native American women, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, that, you know, they said, they, police went on to say it probably was a truck driver, because truck drivers frequent that highway up there. I think it was Alaska or Canada, one of the places, and it was killing these women. And I think they never caught or apprehended the suspect. So there's a lot of things that transpire. When you talk about depopulation, you're talking about people that engage in mass murder. They are mass murderers, you know. Mass murder has a level of 0 to 10 to 10 to 0. You see, this thing is mathematics. You got demonic mathematics. That's what depopulation is. It's demonic mathematics. Who gives a human being or a covenant of human beings to decide behind closed doors how many people supposed to be on earth? See, this is what you got to understand. You got some people that want to be God. They want to be like God-like beings, because they have a little bit of IQ. You know, they pass the basic arithmetics and the calculus and the timetables and the division. and the reading and the sentence structures, how to form paragraphs, the sciences, the biologies, and all the things that go with fundamental building blocks to education. They passed that and they went on. You know, sometimes man can go beyond his limitations. And sometimes those kind of men lose, you know, they lose their mind. They're mad. They go crazy. They're too smart for their own good. And sometimes they tend to go on the demonic side and think, if I know this, I got everything I want. Hell, it's not enough. I want to be a god now. And there you have it. Not only men, women, that's in these secret societies, these demonic secret societies. Because we have a misconception in this. We think every jurisdiction or every lodge, is satanic. Some of those are nothing but hobnob places like clubs. They just, people go there to meet and greet and socialize and drink, get drunk, eating, getting drink till they marry, whatever, fall out or whatever, and have fun. And may engage in orgies or two. You know, it's just like that. I mean, it's like your regular club or strip club, what have you. But it doesn't mean they controlling and moving and shaking world commerce or making deals and making policies in foreign countries and starting wars and instigating strategies to take over people's property and everything. It doesn't mean that. We need to understand this. Y'all probably saying, what are you talking about, man? Well, I'm talking about a lot of topics. I'm just, explaining to y'all. It's a bigger picture out here. I mean, what you see is what you don't see. I mean, what you see, you think you see, you perceive you see, but you don't see it. You got to ask yourself a question as a person. Why are you having problems? Why your relationships ain't going right? Why you see all this mental institution stuff going on YouTube and every social media network? Why do you see this constant debauchery and this disembowelment of words and mindsets? People just talking out of the side of their neck, half of them ain't making no sense. They put out videos, but you can't even connect their videos because they everywhere. Like they are schizophrenic, multiple personalities. That's because it's confusion. And I'm going to tell you something. The internet is a good side to it and it's a bad side. And it's part of the octopus of the Illuminati. It's a propaganda machine. It's a media machine. You get any and everything that come across that. Yeah, I mean, you have got people doing, people have even killed themselves live on the internet. So, I'm just trying to break down some stuff for y'all so y'all can be educated. And this is why you gotta step back sometimes and do a self-evaluation of your life and look in the mirror and say, am I living to my highest potential or I'm living in a realm of demonic spirituality? Like I said, I say it again, a lot of us don't even know what the hell we doing. We just exist. We just got work an everyday job or not have a job or struggling or not struggling, but not living to our God-given talent. And you got to find your niche. You got to find your purpose in life. Something for y'all to think about. Ponder on that. I'm not going to go any longer on this video. Have a good Mother's Day. Peace.